You're doing a 400 amp transfer switch today. There is this question for a lot of people that how does this generator and a standby generator works, and how does it work automatically? The brain of this process is this transfer switch. It detects the power failure and then it will send a command to the generator to turn on, and then when we reach certain speed, it's going to transfer to the generator. There is nothing technically that the homeowner is going to do. Everything is automatic. 5 seconds after the power failure, the generator is going to start. This is something that we can modify. Some devices are 30 seconds, some on 5 seconds from the factory, but we can modify it. Then between 10 to 30 seconds, depending on the temperature of the exterior temperature, it will switch to the generator. When the power comes back, it's going to wait, the transfer switch will wait 30 seconds to see if hydro is reliable, then we'll switch back to utility, to hydro, and then after 1 minute the generator will cool down and goes off. All this process depends on this transfer switch, the speed, the and the setup that we have done on the generator. You don't need to do this, it's just for the test. I turn off the whole house. Generator is going to start after 5 seconds. Between 10 to 30 seconds, it's going to click. It will make a noise, give the power to the house. Generator is on. And then it's going to click. Now the whole house is on the generator.
Okay.
As you can see, the module is blinking. After 5 minutes, it's going to be solid lights.
Okay.
Same thing with the hot water tank. Now, when the power comes back, it's going to wait 30 seconds to see if hydro is reliable. It's not fluctuating. We will wait. 30 seconds. It's okay. Back on hydro. Generator is going to work one more minute to cool down and goes off.
Okay. I never touched that button, right?
No, no, no. It's just for the test.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't need to do anything. Everything is automatic.
Okay. Perfect.
Outside, I'm going to show you the generator main board, and then we will connect it to the Wi-Fi. I'm going to put the cover on. And here, this light has to be always green. And the light indicating on this side is going to be green all the time. When it's green, we are all set. It's going to work automatically. If it's red,
yep.
I'm going to turn it off. But if it's red, it's not working.
Okay.
In a year from now, it's going to be green and yellow at the same time. That's a reminder for the maintenance. Here, it's going to say inspect battery.
Mm-hmm.
On the app, it's going to say inspect battery too.
So that's, it does automatically after a year?
Yeah, exactly.
And we do maintenance once a year?
Exactly. 400 hours of operation, whichever comes first. First one is after 6 months or 25 hours, then it's going to be per year.
That's you guys?
Yeah, we are certified to repair, maintenance, everything. So, yeah, we will take care of the maintenance. We will send you the service contract.
Okay.
If anything wrong, you have 10 years warranty on this. Yeah. There was a promotion, so everything is covered.
Okay.
The only exclusion is the battery and the accessories. So the cold weather kit keeps the oil warm in the winter. This guy. Because the first oil that goes to the engine is the one here, so it keeps it warm. And one for the battery. Winter time, it doesn't freeze.
Okay.
The breaker has to be always on.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, there is no power going to the house. What else? You have any questions? Yeah. No.
I guess the application.
Yes. So we are going to install the app. In the app, you will see how many hours it worked. So far, maintenance reminder. You will see it in there. Any error, you will see it here and on the app.
Okay.
Now we can do the Wi-Fi. I go to the. You need to install the app called the Mobile Link. Yeah. You did install it already?
Yeah, no.
A Mobile Link. And at the same, do you know the Wi-Fi password very hard?